I mean, what a wonderful event this is to have such personalities under one roof. And wow, what an opportunity for our students to interact with people who we used to see in our dreams.
Undoubtedly, Basil.
Of course, I think this historical event deserves the loudest of applause.
Now I kindly request our guests to unveil the stone with their auspicious hands.
Dear friends, a huge round of applause because this is the inauguration of the IT block.
Let's hear for this also. This is the Sterling Foundation of Women's Hostel.
Now, since I can see a lot of energy in the auditorium right now, to just show the kind of energy and enthusiasm that we have, a huge round of applause for all of us. Now, I would request our Honorable Vice Chancellor for the presentation, please.
What Rahul Ji had promised us last September has come true, it's a dream come true. We wanted, the students' demand was that we should have the corporate houses in Kashmir in our university. So they are all here and we should give them a big hand. These gentlemen do not really need any introduction. I am very happy to announce that we have got a special package of 30 crore and that is for our new campus of Zakura. So this is phase one of Zakura, where we are going to move some of the departments because of the overcrowding in the university.
The titans of industry and the young students here. I had come here last year and I had promised you that mine will not be an event. It will be a lifelong journey of understanding. It will be an attempt to understand your perspective, to understand what you have been through, to understand your difficulties. Vice Chancellor has read out what we have done, what we have tried to do. But from my perspective, that is not what is important. From my perspective, it is more important to understand what you are facing, the difficulties you are facing, and to stand with you and work with you to improve the situation in Jammu and Kashmir. Last time, a lot of the students said to me that big businesses don't come to Kashmir. And a lot of you who would be here, who would have been here last time, will recall that I said, why don't we speak to some of the leaders, business leaders, to understand what are the type of things that they worry about. I had mentioned to you that businesses at the end of the day are looking for business. They're looking for a situation which is stable. So I'm very happy to have them here. They're going to have a freewheeling discussion with you. They're going to be blunt with you where that is necessary. They're going to be honest with you where that is necessary, and you should be honest with them. This is a communication, and from my perspective, it is the second communication, and I intend to continue having these communications with you. I intend to build a relationship with you. Finally, a lot of people say that Kashmir is a beautiful place. Today I was staying in the guest house where I used to stay with my grandmother when she was alive. And I was looking outside the window and I said, look, what a beautiful place. I looked at the Dal Lake and I said, what a beautiful place this is. And then I realized that actually the really beautiful thing about Kashmir is not the place, but the people.
I'd like to just say very quickly that I work with a very small NGO in Bombay and incidentally that was started by 5 Kashmiri youth. It's called Miracle Couriers, and it employs mute and deaf to deliver couriers.
It's been a great pleasure to be here, particularly under the initiative taken by Mr. Rahul Gandhi, which has in fact ignited that fire that you speak of. Let me just say that we can all be here and exchange pleasantries, but perhaps what I would like to initiate is to say that we can do something discreet. And what I'd like to offer is that when I return back to Bombay, the Tata Group will establish a program with the university of having internship in a controlled manner that will give the Kashmiri youths a chance to apply, to work side by side with us. And we have found most internships end up in permanent employment.
We are having a massive program of growth in the Kashmir, in Jammu and Kashmir. We are one of the largest employers in Kashmir in our bank. We have about 60 branches, 41, and all this in the last 2.5 years. Most of the growth has come in the last 2.5 years. Similarly, what I'm willing to commit is that in our entire group, we will send our HR people for internship and recruitment to your university every year.
The key is connecting the element of the talent pool or the educated youth that we have to the job market that exists across industries and segments. And as was mentioned earlier, there is a deficit in the aspect of the educational corridor in making the person job ready.
I left the airport. The first 4 motorcycles I saw were Bajaj Pulsar, Bajaj Pulsar, Bajaj Pulsar. And I would be very happy that just as Pulsar is used by people here, I would love it if people from here would come and make some of those Pulsars to be sold and to be used in Kashmir.
The idea is to set up projects that will succeed. And I want them to be blunt with you about what they think will not work and what they think will work. What I want to impress is that this is a journey. It is a journey of all of us. And we will have to work together to say, okay, this is working, this is not working. Let's leave this, let us do this. Let us start this discussion, let us make it a deep discussion.